We are back. Before we went for the break, we're still talking about Tumwine's arrogance. Tumwine, it's so say, it is too much. Okay, I don't even, like, he doesn't care. And what actually surprises me is that the president does not comment anything about this. And that's why I've always disagreed with Andrew Mwenda saying that opposition is made of hooligans. Who is making up NRM? You have, what's his name? I keep on forgetting. That warthog that is the ambassador to Burundi. What's his name? Onyakubo Mkazo, a slap. Charlie Gonza. Man, stretching private parts of women on stage, man, when they are singing. I have done that, but it was in a strip club. There's a difference. Yeah. Me, I found women who are expecting it. So you cannot find a woman on stage when she's dancing, entertaining the people. You do that, man. Charlie Gonza, call me, man. I know that there's a strip club there in Rugaga. Check it. You just watch it and you go away feeling like you need to cleanse your body with like some disinfectant. Check it. The whole place smells nakedness. You enter like this, you go,
There's candida in this bar.
Check it. But you know, we are men. You should enjoy it. But for him, he was doing it for women who are not asking for it. But check it. Then there is Kasirye Gwanga. This man shoots everything. He shoots birds, he shoots tractors, he sets things on fire. See, that man is a lunatic. See, then there is, who's left? Man, I've forgotten all these army generals. There's Eddie Tumwine, who is threatening people to beat them up. And then when they ask him, he's like, they say, we are going to talk to Kadaga, he's like, who is Kadaga? You know? And then there is Brian White. Don't. I know when you say Brian White, like, no, that's one of your people. That's one of your people, that bleached boy. He's yours. Then there's Andrew Mwenda. Hooligan. like, whenever I hear NRM saying that opposition is never, yeah, we have never bought that. You are also hooligans. But you know, why can't you just be decent? Why can't you make a topic? Well, you know, sometimes that's what's funny when you hear President Museveni speaking. Because sometimes he actually speaks. Yes, he's arrogant, but there are lines he doesn't cross. And when Museveni is being arrogant, he knows how to do it with humor. You know, the time he was like, you people keep on covering BCJ when he's not doing anything, yet me, I'm busy teaching people how to mulch. Okay, I'm not saying don't cover him, but you come and cover me when I'm mulching, like for 40 hours, and then get like 2 minutes and go say, oh by the way, also BCJ is shouting. And you come back to me. That's like hilarious, man. That's like a good build up for a joke. Even if you disagree with him, it sounds like he's not, man, you're a chikuwa ko. Man, come on, bro. This is wrong. Needs to stop, and if it doesn't stop, Tumwine, I know where you stay. And I will never be anywhere near you, man, because people would say that you're badass, man. Say, I have a life to live. No, forget all I said. Anyway, let's just read some social media comments. I don't know what people are saying about this whole thing of Eddie Tumwine. Underman Daku, your rank means nothing without brains. Okay. You people use your prefectures if they come for you. You are dealing with human beings and civilians. You need to reason them and understand them. That I agree with. Do not just patronize people. Counter them with logic. We are not in a war zone. Stop using this kind of arrogance, general. Then Agamba, he ended it. He said a very good point and ended it with stupidity. He's the IGP. IGP says so. Baba's Liberty, based on my intellectual capacity and my vast knowledge, tactically and tentatively, right from the beginning of times, especially in the light of ex-Ecclesiastes, who's this now? I have come to a concrete, definite, and profound conclusion that I actually have nothing to say. Man, who put this comment in my things, man? See, that's how people shouldn't be fired from jobs, man. Sure. Medim Toto, and the other ranks are not considered in creating those situations. RIP General Aranda, Kazin, and others. Timothy Tenney, this is exactly what these beloved generals have failed to reconcile with people's expectations. Generals in the USA and UK are meant to be celebrated and praised in the whole country. But it's not the generals to celebrate themselves and blow their own trumpet. That's really a big point. I agree with that. You can't find yourself praising yourself. There's Sandra Yiga, who probably is like cheating on her husband with Sam Yiga. Did God really categorize us like that? I believe he created us and has exclusive rights to classifications of his property. Kenneth Bagumisa, let the general brag. Your father and grandfathers were enjoying their beds when the general was in the bush. Don't expect to reap where you didn't sow. This is bogus, man. That's why I explained that. If you watch the show, you know that no, it doesn't work like that. Bible innocent Wendy. Like, really? This guy is actually called Bible? Man, this is a chiga. Why chiga man? You meet up on Saturday, meet up on Friday. Now you're going to call them Psalms and Proverbs, man, the Bible. I hear, General, Eli has nothing to tell Ugandans apart from reminding them that all the time I was a general, we fought. That I agree with. Like at this time, Muyembe knew that song. It sounds like you don't have any other thing to say. Which they get. Then there's Okito Paul. Your arrogance will have an end as well because you are not the first and last general in the world. Yeah, that's true. You know, kind of true. Harsh truth, but really the truth. Segeda, you don't be arrogant, man. Remember when Mujugisha Mutu was warning Kayura, my friend, be careful. You might not always be in that uniform. Use your brain. When you leave that uniform, think of the people there that you, okay, that's not exactly what he said. But he was trying to tell Kayura that when you're still in uniform, you look like you're untouchable. But one day, you might not be in uniform. So the people that you're treating like crap, treat them well so that when you're out of uniform, they can take care of you. And just like that, the words became so prophetic. Kayura katalaya bidi mbuzi. Smelling, he got urine now, they're urinating on him. So you want to be okay. Let's just move on to another story. Now, this story is sad, but it's funny. You know, I don't know. There's a herdsman that died. He died. But what's funny is that he died in a cell phone explosion. That's funny, man. You know, like, that's funny. I mean, like, death is sad, but you know how you die can be funny, you know? Like, he died in a cell phone. What makes this funny is that there's probably a girl who's catching feelings that is not replying to his texts. I don't know what's up, I don't know message. A girl sent bums and he did not reply. Now the girl is feeling like a prostitute. He's like, I sent you nudes. I took off my clothes for you. And you're not replying? Ngachari muguru. Man, die for a cell phone explosion, man. That's like funny. You know, because now, like, whenever your children see a phone, they remember you. You know, like, this killed dad. You know? First of all, man, so phones are killing people now. Yo, so who do we blame for this? The Chinese? Bad luck? Was it his time to go? And when you reach heaven, how do you explain? How does God explain this to you? Like, when you reach heaven, and someone reaches to you and goes, God, you really took me out with a cell phone explosion? Because me, I've already thought that if you're going to die, this should be something, you know, like something worthwhile. You know, like you die when you are having sex with a very fat woman and she chokes you to death on top of you. That's like dope. Like you go to heaven, you're like, yo, Kadona go, you go. She's like, but man, you died in a cell phone explosion. I don't know how that brings in the aspect of the phone that killed you. If it's like an iPhone, maybe you're like, oh, man, he was killed by an iPhone. You might find it's like some ITEL thing, man. Pah! No offer. What does even a cell phone explosion look like? Man. See, that's why I say that, man, this is a mafia. This guy was executed by the mafia, man. Cell phone explosion. A phone kills people like that? You know, I've heard about it. But until I saw this headline, I actually had never really taken time to process it. Like a cell phone explodes and you die? Jesus, man. So this time I'm holding the phone, man. Let's read some comments about this story, man. This is what people have to say, because, man, me, I failed to get what to say about this. There's some comments about the herdsman. They say Mugoma Evangelist Francisco is like, so sorry. There's a meme, Umuhungu Watoto. Bambi, my fellow herdsman, my condolences. Hey, but. We Sevanji, come here on a story, man. Why are you commenting like this, man? As if you're on steroids. Yusuf Ampurire, he was trying to charge it from the motorcycle engine. He was a good innovator indeed. Jesus. Are you trying to saint this man? Are you trying to turn him into a saint for dying because of a suicide connection? Samuel Adur, tell us the phone brand so we boycott. Like some times back. Like sometime back when Samsung brought Samsung Galaxy Note 7, after explosions, people boycotted the most expensive Note 7 by then. That's okay. I think that's okay. You know, like tell us, man. You say she was killed by, I don't know. Rafumuza Rukanda. Is that the phone that blasts? Yeah. Well, okay. That might be a Getty image, but you know. There's Harriet Atim Dela. So sad. And funny, you know. There's Sam Mujini Camden. UNBS should do its work. Consumers at risk. MHSRIP. May his soul rest in peace. This is the first time I'm seeing someone make an acronym of an entire sentence. No wonder your name looks like that with hyphens, man. Area code UG. Say no to China products. Now, who is going to give you products, man? If not the Chinese. Then there's Beno Chan. Oh, no. Oh, no. Hey, man. It's like someone died of a phone explosion, man. At least power banks. You know, when they say power bank, you think of it like a power bank. Like, there's power, and it's a bank. Maybe there's a lot of power. So far. Anyway, RIP to the man. It is sad. And now that I know about this, I don't know what I'm going to do because I cannot survive without a cell phone. You know, that's what makes this story so complicated. What? We can stay away from phones? We're going to die if this is actually true. Anyway, until tomorrow evening, have a very lovely night.